In the 48 races held at Spa between 1950 and 2015, the race winner has only started from pole position on 16 occasions. Qualifying yesterday may have set the order for today, but expect the unexpected here at the Belgian Grand Prix. As the saying goes, of course, anything can happen. And you know what? It usually does. Spa-Francorchamps today, a circuit that spans 4.35 miles. There are tons of elevation changes along the way too. 19 corners making up this circuit, with 9 of those to the right and the remaining 10 to the left. This track is a great one for fans of pure speed. The average lap speed comes close to a whopping 145 miles an hour. Joining us today to oversee all the thrills and spills, it's Anthony Davidson. Ant, great to see you. How are you feeling about the race today, and how are the circuit conditions from what you've seen?
Well, it's looking a bit cold out there, if I'm honest. These tyres have quite a narrow operating window in terms of the temperatures they need to extract the best grip. So with a cold track surface, it's going to be harder to keep those temperatures up, which will lead to lower grip and maybe more mistakes.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. It's McLaren in pole position there, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Weber, Romain Grosjean, and Vettel, Norris, Perez, Bottas, and Alexander Albon, Giovinazzi, Kubica, Pierre Gasly, and Kvyat, Sainz, Raikkonen, Charles Leclerc, and Nico Hülkenberg. Russell and Devon Butler starts from the back of the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, La Source is always pretty tight, but we've got a clear run. Remember the runoff if you need it. Our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. Threat of rain for the time being. Conditions looking good. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. That's a strong start. Well done. A new fastest lap for the race. Charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy. UK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. by 32.8 seconds. In this lap, push now. Okay, the safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Box this lap, please. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. exit now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Devin is in the pits. Devin in the pits. Energy store is getting worn, reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. okay. The safety car is coming in this lap. We'll be pacing the field in sector 3. Make sure to respect the delta until the safety car is in the pit lane. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. This lap of the race, keep this up. Gap to teammate behind is 14.0 seconds. Of fuel left. So far. Some information on Norris. They seem to have an issue. Everything we wanted today.
Brilliant stuff from McLaren today. What a superb victory. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure, and no doubt they'll be celebrating tonight.